Before proceeding further in this course, in this lecture, I want to do some advanced setup for Postman in order to make testing with Postman a little bit simpler and faster. So far, in order to authenticate a user, we have been copying the token issued for that user and pasting it manually whenever we need it. For example, when we log in a new user, we are going to receive this token. So far what we have been doing is, we have been copying this token and we have been using it on the protected route by specifying it for this authorization header. In the same way, when a new user is created, for that new user also, a token will be issued. So we have been copying that token and using it on the protected routes in order to access it. But now I want to automate that process. So what I want is, whenever a user logs in or a new user is signed up, we want to use that user's token. Now, we don't want to copy it manually. Instead, we want to automate it. So let's see how we can do that. It's a simple three-step process. But before we do that, let me create a collection. I remember I had created a collection earlier, but for some reason that collection has been deleted. Let's call this collection Cineflex. Here we can select the type of authentication, whether we want some authentication for this collection or not, but we are not going to select anything here. And that should be it. So this collection has been created. Let me close it here. And now what I want is, inside this collection, I want to save these requests. So let me go here and let me save this request first. I'll call this request as getAllMovies. Here we want to create this request inside this Cineflex collection. And in there, I want to have a new folder called Movies. So all the movie related API requests we will save inside this Movies folder, and all the user related API requests we will save in the Users folder. So let me go ahead and let me save it here. This request has been saved as getAllMovies. Let's also save this post request. Again, I will call it as createMovie. I want to save it inside the Cineflex folder. Okay, here I don't see any movie folder. So I think the folder has not been created. But anyway, let's save it inside this Cineflex collection. Okay, so the post request has been saved here. But now what I will do is, inside this Cineflex collection, I want to add a new folder. So here we have this add folder button. Let me go ahead and let me rename it. And let's call it as movies. And what I want is, I want to move these two requests inside this movies folder. Okay. Inside this movies folder, we have these two requests. Let me also go ahead and let me add one more folder. And let me rename this folder and I will call it as users. So all the users related requests we will save inside this users folder. So one of the requests which we have here is to sign up a user. So let me go ahead and let me save this one, and I want to save it in users folder, and I'm going to call it sign up. Okay, let's save it. So this is for signing up the user. For some reason, the name has not changed. Let me try to rename it. So let's click here and let's try to rename it and let's call it sign up. Okay, in the same way, let's save this request also. Let's click on the save button. Here in the users folder, I want to call it as login. Okay, so we need to provide the request name here in this first text box. I think last time I provided the name here, maybe that's why I did not save it with that name. Anyway, so now we want to save this login inside the Cineflex collection and in the users folder. Okay, so all these requests are saved. And we will also save the patch and delete request which we have for the movies route, but we'll do it later. All right, now let's go ahead and let's try to automate the process of copying this token and using it for the authorization header. For that, the first thing which we need to do is, we need to create an environment. So just like we have created a development and production environment for our Express app, in the same way here also we need to create environment. So here you can see currently no environment is selected, but let's go ahead and let's create two environments. So you can click on this add button. and I will call this environment as dev Cineflix. Okay. And for this environment, currently, if you see, we don't have any environment variable. But if you want, we can have some environment variable for this environment, for this dev Cineflix environment. And for now, I'm going to add one environment variable here, which I will call URL. And then let's specify the value for that. So it is going to be http://127.0.0.1 and the port number, which will be 3000, and then slash. So this is our root URL. So we can also call it as root URL, but I will simply call it as URL. So this is the environment variable which we want to have. And for now, this should be it. So let's go ahead and let's save this environment. Okay. And we can also create a production environment here, but currently I'm not going to create that environment. We'll simply use this development environment for our testing purpose. And now let's go ahead and let's use these environment variables in our request. So let's go to this get all movies, and there, instead of specifying this URL here, this 127.0.0.1, there we can use our environment variable. And to use environment variable, we need to use a double set of curly braces like this, and in there we specify the variable name, which in this case is URL. Okay, so if I hover over this URL, it should show us the value. So this is the value for that URL variable. Okay, let's save it. And let's do the same thing for other requests. So let me copy this from here. Let's go to this create movie. There also, let's replace this and save it. Let's go to sign up. There also, let's do the same thing. Save it. Let's go to login. And here also, let's replace it. And let's save it. Let me close this tab, and let's also close this environment tab. Now, just to check everything is working as expected, let's simply make a request, and if we get the result in the response, so we are getting some result in the response, but we are not getting a list of movies here because again, the JWT has expired. So what I will do is, I will go ahead and I will increase the expired time. So for that, let's go to this config.in file. So basically, we are specifying this time interval in milliseconds. So in seconds, it is around 10,000 seconds. Okay, so let me go ahead and let me add three more zeros here. So now it is 1 million seconds. Let me save the changes and let me rerun this application. So I will save this authcontroller.js. And now, again, this application is up and running. Anyway, so this is working as expected. That means this URL here, it is working as expected. Now, what is the advantage of doing this? Well, the advantage here is that later, when we will create the production environment here, there also we will create an environment variable called URL, and there for that URL, we will specify the production environment URL. Okay, so in that case, we will not have to change this URL here. We will simply change the environment from here, and from that environment, this URL will be read. So instead of changing the URL in all these requests, we will simply change the environment. And from that environment, this URL will be taken and that URL will be used. I hope you got the point. Next, we are going to automate the process of copying the token and pasting it in the authorize header. For that, we will have to write a single line of code in Postman, but that's easy, and that too, we don't need to write it manually. And we are going to do it for sign up and login, because these are the two places from where we will get the JSON web token, right? So let's first go ahead and let's do it for this sign up request. Now, what we need to do here is we need to create an environment variable here again, but this time we are going to create this environment variable programmatically. Earlier, we created the environment variable manually, right? But now we are going to create it programmatically. For that, we need to go to tests. And from there, here we have some snippets. From here, we can select the one which we need. In this case, we want to create an environment variable, so we can select this one. Okay. And this is for get, so this is not what we need. We need for set. So let me move this a little bit down. And here we have set an environment variable option. So let's select that. Now here, let's replace this variable key with JWT, because that's the name of the environment variable we want to set. Okay, so this JWT will be the environment variable. And the value for this JWT, we need to read it from the response. So to read it from the response, we can say PM, which stands for postman dot response. Okay, and first we need to convert this response to JSON. So here we have our response. And from this response, we want to read this token variable, right? So here we can say dot token. Okay, so this token basically here is this token property which we are receiving in the response. This expression here, it is going to give us the response. And from that response, we are reading the token property. Now, if you have named this property something else like JWT or JSON Web Token, something like that, then you need to use that property name here. So again, let's save this here. Let's go ahead and let's create a new user. So for that, let's go to this body. And there I'm going to create test2 user. And for that test2 user, let's say email is test2@gmail.com. I'm not going to specify this password changed yet. So let me go ahead and let me remove it. Let's remove this comma also. And let's create this user. And here we have this error. There is already a movie with name undefined. Please use another name. Let me open Compass first. And there, let's check if we have any user with the name test. And here you can see we already have a user with the name test2. And this email test2@gmail.com. So this test2@gmail.com, basically this email field is unique. So if we try to create a new user with the same email, it will not create it. But the thing is, here we are receiving this error message. There is already a movie with name undefined. So why do we have this error? That let's check. So let's go to VS Code. And from here we are signing up the user. So basically we are using this async error handler here in this case. So if something goes wrong, that will be handled here. But let's go to this errorcontroller.js. And here you see in the production environment, we are handling these errors. And one of the error is this error code 11,000, which stands for duplicate key error. So let's go to this function. And here we have that function. And here we are saying, okay, so here we are explicitly specifying this movie. And we are looking for this name parameter. But here, the duplicate key error has happened on the email field. But since there is a duplicate key error, we have this error message. We will modify this error message later. For now, let's test this functionality. So here, I will create another user with the name test3 and with email as test3@gmail.com. And we know that with this email, we don't have any user in the users collection. So let's create this user now. And that user has been created. And now let's open this environment variable, and you can see that a new environment variable called JWT with that token value has been created here. So this token value is basically this token which we have received when we have signed up the user. Okay, so this is working as expected. Now let's do the same thing for login also, because when a user logs in that case also, we want to get the JSON Web Token and we want to assign it to JWT environment variable. So again, let's go to test. Let me paste that code here and let's save it. So it should also be working. Finally, we want to use this JWT environment variable while accessing the protected routes. To do that, let's go to one of the protected routes. In our case, we have two protected routes, get all movies and get movie. And since we are working so far with get all movies, let's do it on this get all movies route. So here the first thing which we will do is let's go to header, and from here let's delete this authorization header. For that, we can simply click on this delete button. So that has been deleted. Now we can go to this authorization tab, and from here we can select the type of authorization, and just like we did earlier, here we want to select the bearer token, because if you remember, we learned that when we set an authorization header, there we first specify this bearer and then the JSON Web Token. So we are going to select this option. And when we select this option, here we need to specify the token. Now here, in order to specify the token, again, we are going to use the JWT environment variable. And to use an environment variable, first we need to use a double set of curly braces like this. And in there, we specify the name of the environment variable. which in this case is JWT. Okay, so if I hover over this JWT, we can see that value. Let's save it. And now let's test this GetAllMovies API. So if the JWT is wrong, or if we have not provided the JWT, we should not get all the movies in the response. Otherwise, if the JWT is there, and if that JWT is correct, then only we should get all the movies in the response. So if I click on the send button, if we get all the movies, all right, it says you are not logged in. So let me go to this login tab here. Let's go to body and let's try to log in this user, john@gmail.com. So when we make a request here to log in this user, so this user has been logged in, and now the JWT variable will be assigned with this value. Okay, let's go back to get all movies and let's make the request again. Okay, again it shows you are not logged in. Let's go to headers tab, and there let's see if the authorization has been set or not. So you can see this authorization has been set with this value, and we will get this error basically when the token does not exist. So let me put a breakpoint here and let's see why we are not getting this token. So let's go to this run and debug, and let's debug this application. Let's select this process. Okay, debugger is attached. Let's go to Postman. Let's make a request. Let's go back again. And here, if I say F10, we have this test token here. And in this test token, this B is in caps. Maybe because of that, it is not reading the token. So let's say step over again. Okay, and you see it did not went inside this line. That's maybe because of this lowercase b error. So let me stop it here and let's make it as capital B. Let's save the changes and let's go back to Postman and let's try to make the request again. And now we are getting all the movies in the response. So that was the issue. Okay, so you can see the authorization header, it is automatically set, and we don't need to copy the token and then paste it manually. It will be taken care by the Postman now, because now we have set some environment variables and we are using them. And currently we have only created one environment, which is this dev Cineflex, but in future we will create the production environment as well in order to test these APIs in the production. So this is all from this lecture. If you have any questions, then feel free to ask it. Thank you for listening and have a great day.